of another movie viewing with May to December. I mean, Malcolm of May to December. And the movie we are watching is The Possession of... I forgot what the name was. What was it? The Possession of Michael Caine. And here's Malcolm about to set the movie up, I think.
It's the movie, if anyone can see it.
They can see it.
The Possession of Michael Caine. It looks like a cheap, crappy possession movie, so I thought, why not watch it with my buddy?
Brother from another mother.
Yeah, the big Johnson.
Okay. So we'll watch that and then we'll give our thoughts after.
Okay, okay.
Okay, guys! Take care for now! Woo! Yes. He looks like Christopher Lloyd.
He does a little bit.
I'll need some of your essence. Saliva?
We are back after the movie of The Possession of... I keep forgetting the rest bit.
Michael Caine.
Michael who? Michael Caine! Yes! Well, I actually thought it was a bit strange, to be honest with you. You kind of, from the beginning, to me, it looked as though that this guy wanted to find out about demonology stuff. And to me, it just ended out that he was, that he got possessed by something. I was watching it, but I didn't really know what amount of what was going on in it, to be honest. But you?
I know a bit about what was going on, but it was a bit confusing at times.
Yeah.
Are you guys anything else? Maybe you want me to say something?
You can, because I'm a bit lost about it.
Okay, so at the beginning, basically, you see some footage of, like, they Michael, his wife, and his daughter had. And basically, then it shows Michael talking to a tarot card reader. And he's got a coin in his hand, but he keeps messing about with on the table. And he's kind of messing around with what he's doing, and he's saying about it to Terry, then, and told her she was going to become an actress, but they would have left and gone somewhere, she won't be dead. Which she thinks a bit, you know, it's a choice if you stay. And when she's looking at tarot cards, the devil comes up, which is a real cliche, really, for tarot reader things. Because not all tarot cards mean what people think they do, like death doesn't always mean death. So then it kind of shows him saying that he wants to make a documentary with his friends. I can't remember his name. I think his friend's name was Jacob or James or something. And basically, they're going around talking to these different places. Like, first it's like the tarot reader, for instance, a necromantic, a rich person, and a necromantic. And basically, he does all these things to see if supernatural stuff exists, like being possessed and all this stuff. And he ends up with Dead Pill's teeth basically sewn into his stomach and all this weird stuff happens. And he ends up being possessed and basically the demon inside him wants him to kill his daughter. And he goes outside to kill someone else, but it's a bum, basically a homeless guy on the street. But he can't do it. Because he cares more about a homeless guy than his own daughter, I guess. Then he handcuffs himself to the bed and basically he sees a video footage of him killing his friend, which is a load of rubbish as well. And and it got, then there's a bit where he cuts a pentagram on his chest and all this, and he shows up and says he doesn't feel the pain anymore. What else happens? What else? Oh, he tries to commit suicide 3 times, and apparently the 3rd time it works. He electrocutes himself the 2nd time, takes an overdose the 1st time, which comes out through blood in his mouth, jumps into a bath full of water and gets electrocuted, but apparently that doesn't work. And then to finish it off, he jumps out through a window. Why? Because Sam comes back and talks through him while spinning around the coin that he was playing with. Because what happens is, in the end, it turns out that she got killed because she was taking that car, the coin to the car, to point the meter, and she dropped the coin, and basically the coin fell on the floor, and she had to pick up, and the car hit her and killed her. And that's basically what the whole film was about, basically. Load of shit.
Yeah, I think I totally agree with you. Is that a milkshake?
Yeah. Cheers.
I had a strawberry milkshake yesterday.
Nice. What, homemade?
No.
McDonald's.
Is it homemade?
Yeah, this is homemade milkshake. I always have homemade milkshake.
Well, how does Donna make it?
Well, she gets the syrup, the Nesquik stuff, and then she gets some milk and she stirs it.
Well, that's the original way of making them, isn't it? That's good, though.
Yeah, she does it. Sometimes she puts ice cream in it, if I'm lucky.
That's nice. So, what do you think the next film would be?
Well, it won't be a Possession movie, because they suck. Probably Death Valley or Witchfall.
Okay. Okie dokie. What day would you like to do it?
I don't know, yeah. What day's your friend?
I'm free Sunday or Monday.
Okay, maybe we'll do it on Monday. Not Monday, Sunday, sorry.
Okay. Sunday, my brother from another mother.
Yeah, because my brother's mothers is his brother's mothers, and then some each other's mothers and each other's brother's mothers, and that's how we do it, because our mother's mothers is each other's mother's mothers, and the mothers of the brothers and the brothers of the mothers.
Do you want to say your goodbye?
Goodbye. Goodbye, thanks for watching this video. Sorry it can't be more detailed. It was just a really shit movie.
Are you gonna give your full length review of it later or not?
I will be, but I'll probably be shorter than this one.
Okay. Anyway guys, until Sunday with our next one. Goodbye and take care as always. Woo!